Hey again, math class. Okay, so in the last video, we talked a little bit about how fractions can have any number on the bottom when they're written like this. But in decimals, it's mostly going to be ones and zeros on the bottom, and most often this sum number in the numerator over 100, and then writing that as a decimal point. And so we would say this tenths, hundredths, thousandths, ten thousandths, we would have hundred thousandths, and millionths, okay? And they correspond to place value behind the decimal point. And so that's what we're going to talk about now. So let me show you this very colorful number that I created. And so everything on this side of the screen, on this side over here, those are all whole numbers, right? They're to the left of the decimal point. And so these are the numbers that we are most used to using, right? This is what we've kind of been working with so far. And if I had to give them their titles, let me turn this, I would say that 2 is in the ones place. This is in the tens place, right? Does this sound familiar? That 3 is in the hundreds place. That 1 is in the thousands place, right? Thousands. So hopefully those all look familiar. And another thing to think about is as we go this way with whole numbers, they get bigger. They get bigger going that way, okay? From like this decimal point area out, right? I mean, you'd much rather have $1 million than $1,000, right? Because the million, as you work out this way, let me add some other numbers here so you can see, the millions place out here is way more money than like just the 1,312. It's the opposite way with with these fractional decimal things, with behind the decimal point. As we go out this way, it actually gets smaller. Okay? So that's something to think about and just sort of keep in mind as we're talking about things, especially when we get to like comparing decimals, because you're going to want to say, well, you know, this number is bigger than something that only has two places, because that's how it works on the whole number side. That's not how it works, really. That's not how it works on the decimal side. And each of these places has a name that pertains to these fractions that we were talking about, right? So this first spot, that's the 10 behind the decimal. We kind of talked about that in the last video. If I have 10, I'm going to do one place behind the decimal. Let me turn this here. This is called tenths. Tenths. So just like tens over here, only I've added a ths. And the other thing that you want to remember is that we skip the ones place, okay? There's not like a once. I don't know why, probably because it's hard to say. This second spot right here, what comes next on this whole number side, right? What comes next? Hundreds. So this is our hundredths place. Hundredths place. And if you notice, those were all those numbers that we were doing in the last video that they were pictures out of 100. Let me see if I can grab one here just to show you. I just happen to have them right here. Yeah, so see, like this guy, right? It was out of 100 pieces. I put it over 100 if I'm writing a fraction. It's 1, 2 spots behind the decimals. So 66 hundredths in this case. In this example, it would be 48 hundredths, right? That next spot, 3 spots behind the decimal place, is called, let me see here, thousandths. Thousandths. Okay? 4 spots behind the decimal point. What is that one called? Well, over here, what's the one after 1,000? This would be 10,000, right? That's the same over here. This would be 10 thousandths. 10 thousandths. The 5 right there. He is in the 100 thousandths place. 100,000ths. Whoop, I'm off the screen. And that last number right there, just like on the other side over there, is in the millionths. Millionths, okay? But different than in whole number land, you don't want to have millionths of a decimal. You would much rather have millions, because this over here, right, he's the bigger guy. This is very, very, very small, okay? So if I was only looking at this portion right here, how would I say that number? I'm going to say it just like it was in whole numbers. Okay, so if it was a whole number, it would be 482,153, right? That's how I say it. It's going to be 482,153, and then I tack on whatever place this guy, my last number, is in, I tack on his decimal word. So, 482,153 millionths. Ooh, that is ugly, ugly. Let's maybe look at a different number here. What if this was my number? Okay, just two spots behind the decimal point. I would say that as 48, because if it was a whole number, if that decimal point wasn't there, it's just 48, right? But then I have to tack on his decimal word for this last place. Let me move this so we can still see it, which is hundredths, right? So I say 48 hundredths. What if I wanted this to be the number that I had to say? So again, if it was a whole number and all of this other writing was gone, it would be 4,821, right? But it's behind the decimal, so I got to tack on the decimal word. 4,821 ten thousandths.